Boris senses movement. He dives, keeping any exposure to the minimum. When Boris is underwater, his scales, known as osteoderms, create a low pressure system around him, resulting in a countercurrent around his body. The water surface won't ripple as he swims up to his prey. He's invisible. This one is an ambush specialist. The green tree python is a non-venomous arboreal snake. It lives in the rainforests of the very far north of Queensland. Tropical country and full of prey. As a juvenile, it spends a lot of time on the ground, hunting small lizards and frogs. So its colouring is mottled yellow to blend in with the leaves on the rainforest floor. As it becomes adult, it turns a stunning green, the perfect camouflage in the tree canopy. It catches rodents on the ground at night. By day, it takes to the trees in search of canopy-dwelling animals. After getting into a good position, the green tree python sits and waits for prey to come within strike range. Many of its prey are well adapted to sea movement. So this snake has come up with a means to exploit that. It doesn't just passively wait for its victims. It tries to actively attract them. It wriggles the very end of its tail. This is called caudal luring. By doing this, it's trying to convince any passing reptile or bird that the tip of its tail is actually a juicy snack, like a small lizard. It's a classic ambush, with a twist. However, this species of jumping spider is an expert at disguise. It's tricked the ants into thinking it's one of them. The ants rely less on vision and more on chemical signals to tell them what is friend and what is foe. By adopting their chemical signature, the spider is able to remain undetected. The spider's chemical mimicry isn't just a clever defense mechanism, but also an aggressive predatory ploy. Because the ants think the spider is one of them, they won't stop it entering their nest, where it will prey on their eggs, larvae, and pupae. To be able to penetrate the defences of the weaver ant nest is remarkable. It's one of the most formidable fortresses in the forest. And it's built by a mighty army of these highly resourceful ants. Found in Africa and Asia as well as Australia, a colony of weaver ants can be 500,000 strong. Alone, a single weaver ant is tiny and vulnerable. But together, they become a mighty, many-celled workforce. The venomous death adder also lies in wait for prey. This mouse has good senses of its own. But the death adder's colouring means that once it digs itself into the leaf litter, it's almost invisible. It lurks there, deathly still. The unsuspecting mouse walks right over the top of it. Although the death adder doesn't have heat pits like most of the pythons, it picks up the vibrations of the rodent. And when the mouse is close, the snake can use its eyesight to zero in on its target. The death adder has one of the fastest strikes of all snakes. It can attack, inject its venom, and be back into its original position in a quarter of a second. The kill is often swallowed head first. If the snake is low on venom, its prey may still be alive for a while after being bitten. Eating head first reduces the risk of the snake being bitten itself. All snakes are very vulnerable whilst they're eating. Their main weapons are now out of play. So they need to get every meal down as quickly as possible. And head first is the fastest. Powerful enzymes and gastric juices break down the food, and the nutrients are absorbed. This process can take days or even weeks. The eastern tarantula. She's one of the biggest spiders in the country, up to 6 inches across. Her venom is powerful enough to kill a dog. This spider lives on the ground in the drier areas of the forest. She's excavated a burrow around 3 feet deep. Alone, she waits just inside the burrow entrance. The tarantula is an ambush predator. This spider relies more on touch than sight. As she patiently waits, the cricket passes near her burrow. Its movements are producing telltale vibrations. It's all over in seconds. With the tarantula around, the forest floor is never a safe place for potential prey like crickets. It's been dry season now for over 5 months. There hasn't been rain in a long time. Waterholes are developing thick mud at their edges. Rivers are low. and animals coming down to the water's edge to drink can be excellent quarry for the stealthy crocodile. Salties are hypercarnivores, meaning their diet is more than 70% meat. They'll eat just about any animal they can catch and overpower, including fish, birds, small animals, even humans. Like all estuarine crocodiles, Boris is mostly nocturnal. But will hunt during the day when he gets a chance. He gets into position along the riverbank to watch for anything that comes within striking distance. Sweeps of his powerful tail propel him silently through the water. His short limbs with clawed, webbed feet are ideal for swimming. His eyes, ears, and nostrils are located on top of his head, allowing him to lie low while keeping an eye on his prey. As well as a good sense of smell, he has sensory pits along his entire body, which detect vibrations. Boris senses movement. He dives, keeping any exposure to the minimum. When Boris is underwater, his scales, known as osteoderms, create a low pressure system around him, resulting in a countercurrent around his body. The water surface won't ripple as he swims up to his prey. He's invisible. The little moorhen in the reed beds is oblivious to his presence. Boris is after a bigger prize. He moves on silently. An unsuspecting wallaby has come to the water to drink. Unaware of what may lurk nearby. A crocodile can lunge incredibly fast, using both feet and tail to propel himself from the water. Boris clamps the wallaby with his long, powerful jaws. A special valve at the back of his throat allows him to open his mouth to catch and hold prey under the water without any entering his throat. But to eat the wallaby, his head needs to be above water. A crocodile can eat an incredible 23% of its body weight in one go, He can secrete gastric acid faster than any other animal, liquefying bone matter in just a few hours. The only thing Boris can't digest is keratin, so he'll cough up the fur later. Anything he can't manage now, he'll conceal and return for snacks when he's hungry.